This is part 3 of solving equations containing radical expressions, and we'll be solving these 3 equations in this video. To solve this problem, since it has a square root in it, we want to isolate the square root. Well, you can either put the square root on the right-hand side of the equation, or you could leave it on the left and subtract x from both sides. I'm going to go ahead and put it on the right side of the equation. Now, when you put it on the right side of the equation, that means there'll be a minus sign in front of the square root. So we have minus the square root of x plus 5, and then I'm going to have to subtract 7 from both sides, so that gives you x minus 7. So this is what it looks like if I put the square root on the right-hand side of the equation. Now, even though I do have a minus sign in front of that square root, that's okay. I could still square both sides, and just remember that's a negative 1 times a negative 1 when I square it. So we could do that. Let's square both sides. All right, on the left-hand side, either you know the formula for squaring a binomial, or if you want, you can always write x minus 7 times x minus 7 and do the FOIL method to get your answer. I'll leave that to you, but after doing the FOIL method, you should get x squared minus 14x plus 49. And on the right-hand side, when you're squaring this, well, when you square the negative 1 times negative 1, you just get a positive 1. And then you square the square root, you're just going to get what's underneath that, which is x plus 5. All right, now we're going to analyze this. What do I have left? I have an x squared term, so it's a quadratic. So to solve a quadratic, I need to get everything up one side of the equation and 0 on the other side. So I'm going to have to subtract x and subtract 5 from both sides. At any time, feel free to put this on pause and finish it on your own, and then go back and see if you can get the same answer I'm getting. All right, so what we have is x squared minus 15x plus 44 equals 0. And now we want to factor the left-hand side. So let's see, this factors to x minus 11 and x minus 4. That gives you the right middle and last term. And so we have to set each of those equal to 0. X minus 11 equals 0, or x minus 4 equals 0. So x is 11, or x is 4. But one of the most important things about solving square root problems is you must check your answer in the original equation. In fact, in every single equation you solve, you should always check it, but especially with square roots, because sometimes when you square something, you get extra solutions that really don't work in the original. All right, so what we want to do is check each of these in the original. All right, so first let's check x equals 11. So we're going to put an 11 for x. So 11 plus the square root of 11 plus 5. All right, so this gives me 11 plus the square root of 16. And the square root of 16 is 4. And 11 plus 4 is 15. So the left-hand side simplifies to 15. The right side 7, so no, this does not check, okay? So x equals 11 is not a solution, does not check. All right, now let's check 4. Put in 4 for x. All right, so on the left side here, we have 4 plus square root of 9, which is 4 plus 3, which is 7. And we had a 7 on the other side. So x equals 4 does check. So that means the solution to this problem is 4. That's the only one that checks in the original equation. All right, here's another problem that we haven't solved that looks like this yet because it has a cube root. But basically the same steps apply. We want to isolate the cube root. So let's subtract 5 from both sides. That's the cube root of 2x equals 4. And now to undo the cube root, I need to cube both sides. So instead of squaring both sides, if it's a cube root, the only difference is we'll cube both sides. If it's a fourth root, we'll raise each side to the fourth power. All right, so when the cube root of 2x cubed then gives me 2x, what's underneath the cube root sign. And 4 cubed means 4 times 4 times 4, which is 64. Right, so we get the equation 2x equals 64. Just divide both sides by 2, and we get 32. Now it's important we check this in the original. So now let's go ahead and check it. So the original was cube root of 2x plus 5 equals 9. And we're going to put in 32 for x on the left-hand side. So the cube root of 64 plus 5. Now, the cube root of 64 is 4, right? Because 4 cubed is 64. So we have 4 plus 5 is 9. We have 9 on the other side. So yes, this checks. So the solution here is indeed 32. That was easy compared to the ones we've been doing. So here's a similar problem. It also has a cube root. So put the video on pause and try this one on your own. All right, let's see, how would we start? We want to again isolate the cube root, so we want to add 5 to both sides. So we have the cube root of x minus 4 equals negative 2. Now, remember if it said the square root of something was negative 2, we would stop right there. That's impossible. But a cube root can be negative. The square root, the fourth root, the sixth root, the eighth root, if you have an even index in here, you take the principal root and it will never be negative. But in this case, this is okay because it's a cube root. So now we want to cube both sides. Okay, to undo that cube root. So we get what's inside, which is just x minus 4 when I cube the cube root. And negative 2 to the third power is negative 8. So now we just add 4 to both sides. Get our x equals negative 4. Right, and of course we want to make sure that's the correct answer. So now we need to check our work in the original. So here's the check. All right, so we're going to put in negative 4 in place of x. So negative 4 minus 4 is what's underneath that cube root minus the 5. So the cube root of negative 4 minus 4 is negative 8 minus the 5. So here we are, the cube root of negative 8. Remember when you're taking the cube root of a negative, you could just pull the negative out if you want, and then that's negative the cube root of 8. Or you might notice that the cube root of negative 8 is just negative 2. So you don't have to write this step right here. That's up to you. That gives you negative. Cube root of 8 is 2. So negative 2 minus 5 is negative 7. And the right-hand side was negative 7. So this did check. So the solution is negative 4. So the solution to this is negative 4.